Now to our story of adventure in one of the world's most volatile regions. The Karakoram Range is home to some of the highest and deadliest mountains on Earth. It's also seen as the decades-old conflict over Kashmir and a more recent upsurge in Islamist militancy. To show you why it can be so difficult for outsiders to access this vast mountain range, take a look at our map. We're talking about the region where China, India and Pakistan meet. And you can see, I think, the line of control there snaking through Kashmir, where the mountains form a natural barrier. Well, American mountaineer Steve Swenson has just returned from his 16th expedition to the Karakoram Range. Over 35 years, he ticked off many peaks, including K2 and Everest. And Steve Swenson is with us now in the Impact studio. And Steve, I guess the appeal of this range to you is partly it's unclimbed, or many peaks were unclimbed and you wanted to be there.
Yes, I think for climbers, being able to do the first ascent of major peaks like this in the world is what we really want to do. And in the Karakoram, because of the conflict over Kashmir, many of these areas have been closed over the years, and as they reopen and go through this process of opening and closing, there's new areas that open up where we can go climbing, and the peaks there have not seen any foreign tourists before.
And even when it's open officially, you still have to go through everything to get the visas, get in, and we've got a picture of the camels behind you getting the kit to the start of the expedition.
Yes, well, even before we leave, there's a very difficult and lengthy permitting process because these areas are so heavily militarized, and there's a lot of security concerns that all these countries have about us going there. And then once we get there, you know, it's such a remote area that from the end of the road to actually where we're climbing, we have to go through a lot of difficult trekking, just sometimes for a week or two to get there.
I mean, I remember reading in your book, Karakoram, a story of the camels going across a fast-flowing river. And, you know, some of your porters can't swim.
Well, that's true. Well, none of them know how to swim. And as the summer progresses and the snow melt runs into these river valleys, the rivers get deeper. So there's, you know, a period of time when you can cross these rivers. And in that particular expedition where we went to the north side of K2 from the Chinese side, the rivers that were, for political reasons, we'd gotten there later than we had thought, and the rivers were quite deep.
Now, I know you've climbed Everest, but that perhaps your heart is with some of these peaks in the Karakoram Range that are, let's say, there isn't an industry around them, that they're different.
Well, unfortunately for the local people, there hasn't been as much of an infrastructure developed for foreign tourists because people are afraid to go there because of the concerns over security. And, you know, so when we go there, we have to do a lot of more of that work ourselves. Whereas for, you know, tourism in places like Nepal, you know, it's much easier.
You bring up the people, and reading your book, the story is not just about you, Steve, and your expeditions and the technical difficulties. It is about people like the gentleman behind us. Rasul, tell us about him.
Well, Rasul, for me, in my book that I've written about the Karakoram, it really personifies to me the blight of the Baltian and Hunza people. These people that live up in northeastern Pakistan in the mountains, they really haven't been able to develop a real viable tourist industry like you would see in other beautiful and dramatic mountain areas in the world because of security concerns, you know, that foreign tourists have over the conflict in Kashmir, and more recently because of you know, the militants that have been infiltrating in other parts of Pakistan from tribal areas along the border with Afghanistan.
And there was an example, wasn't there, of an attack just a few years ago in Pakistan that affects all the villages there?
Well, there was an attack in 2013 on climbers at the base camp in Nanga Parbat. Although technically Nanga Parbat is further south and to the west, and because it's on the other side of the Indus River, technically it's not part of the Karakoram, and closer to those areas where the militants have been infiltrating. I think when you get further to the northeast in the actual Karakoram, you're quite safe because there's a natural border from the mountains, and the people that live in the mountains are a different religious group that are very, very friendly towards us.
And do you hope there'll be more people following in your footsteps in this extraordinary range of mountains?
I think it would be wonderful. I think once you get into the area of Gilgit-Baltistan, people are completely safe. Those, as I mentioned, those people are very friendly and peaceful, and they're like the Sherpas in Nepal. And you know, once you get there, I think though that people hear a lot, you know, they see a lot in the media about Pakistan, and they're afraid to go there. And as a result, you know, people like my friend Rasul and his family, and those people are all impacted by that in a negative way.
Well, Steve, thank you very much for talking about some of your experiences.